I'm pretty sure that all the book lovers out there have faced moments when they really wanted to purchase new books because we can never have enough of them, but their pockets didn't allow to do so. Today, I have come up with a list of 11 books which I bought from Amazon or Flipkart just under 100 rupees. And secondly, they have good ratings. But before starting, please do subscribe this channel. The Alchemist, written by Paulo Coelho. Everything on this earth is being continuously transformed because the earth is alive and it has a soul. And the line written here is, in the book itself, a fable about following your dream. Overall, the book tells us that we must not run away from our destiny. This book is full of ideas about spirituality, destiny and dreams. A highly recommended book for people aspiring for high aims and chasing their dreams. Agatha Christie's Hickory Dickory Dock. This is overall a great book. Surprisingly, Poirot came across very cold and rude, initially so much less amiable. Honestly, there was very less of Poirot here, and I thought some of the questions were left unanswered. But overall, a great book, and the ending was really unexpected. Sense and Sensibility by Jane Austen. This book is such a good read, especially if you want something to learn. Dramatic and witty, this is the first novel I have read of Jane Austen. If there was one thing I enjoyed about this book is the way it uses the morals and values of English country life. Never try to win a traitor's heart. Another thing I liked is the building up of the characters. Overall, it's the best book I have read so far. Wuthering Heights by Emily Bronte. I have read Wuthering Heights a few times and found its rich language and imagery amazing. However, one thing that looked odd about it was that its characters are so lacking in terms of sense of humor. The story seems to be happening in a very different realm than reality. Even the central character seems to be walking blindfolded. He keeps knocking against the walls throughout the story without no light or sense of direction. The flow is nice, and if you like reading gothic novels and horror comics, then you will love it. Some readers will find it boring because the author does not offer any relief till the end. Tragedy after tragedy, and there is no sign of light till Heathcliff is dead at the end. Preeti Shenoy's It's All in the Planets. There is something about love and romance that no matter how much you want to pull yourself away, one day you will find yourself reading one of those stories. This was my first novel by Preeti Shenoy, and though the story was good, there is too much emphasis on planets or astrology, which makes you cringe sometimes. I read the predictions at the beginning of the initial chapters, but as I went along, I just started skipping them altogether and continued to the story. The plot revolves around lives of two people who meet on a journey, start interacting, and by the end up together. The emotions of the characters are captured beautifully, and the language is really simple for beginners. You can either take it up on a lazy day, enjoying the whole scene slowly, or as a quick read as well. Wings of Fire, an autobiography by APJ Abdul Kalam. A very detailed description of how great things can be achieved through simple thoughts. Always keep your dreams high, goals clear, plan perfect, and work through people. Finally, it is people who matters and inspire them through exceptional human touch. Dr. Kalam proved beyond words, keep head high and feet firmly in ground. Understand the environment, motivate people, and guide with vision. And unstinted hard work, wonders can be achieved. This book, every student during his school days may at the age of 15 or 16 should read. Leadership lesson is given. How to face life, solve the struggles, country to keep first, personal requirement always afterwards. Keep clean heart, clear focus, strong faith in Almighty, and he achieved all success. Every time he didn't succeed, but work more and more. Corrected and believed in himself to convey to success. Never miss reading this book. This book is Hind Swaraj by Mahatma Gandhi. This book is full of knowledge like a sea. You must read this book if you are really interested in Gandhian principle. This book will give you a brief knowledge of Indian culture, society, and other machinery who have ruled over India. The hypocrisy and perversion of parliamentary democracy stands exposed, and it is available in Hindi and English too. A wonderful and gripping tale mixed with fantasy and contemporary elements, Harappa, The Curse of the Blood River by Vineet Bajpayee. Why I was intrigued towards reading this book because of the title itself, Harappa. I have never read anything about the civilization, of course, except the course books. So when I got a chance to review this book, I grabbed it instantly and I was not disappointed at all. Next is Revolution 2020 by Chetan Bhagat. Oh man, one of the best books I have ever read. I didn't even notice that how much hours passed by when I was reading this. For the people who didn't read this, please spend that money and read it. You'll never regret spending for this. This book is a mixture of all our emotions. The Theory of Everything by Stephen Hawking. He describes the universe from the viewpoint of Aristotle, Newton, Einstein, Augustine, Hubble, Friedman, Galileo, and several other scientists and philosophers. He explains as to why aren't we able to notice several other dimensions when it actually exists. He further explains as to how physics doesn't distinguish between the past and the future, and how the concept of time is just an illusion to our understanding. The language used is simple and easy and is definitely a boon for those curious to gain insight more about the laws of universe from a scientific point of view. The 5 AM Club by Robin Sharma. Finally, I completed reading the 5 AM Club book. I would like to recommend it as one of the mind-changing books. Like, it has really changed my perspective towards everything, like towards world, towards people, and most importantly towards my work. The book isn't just about waking up at 5 a.m. but it has many great insights which I never knew earlier and I believe many of us need to know. The way all the learning models are explained beautifully yet in a simpler manner.